Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel with me, Miss Rina. Okay, today we will study about reported speech. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Halo semuanya, kembali lagi dengan saya, Miss Rina. Nah, hari ini kita akan belajar tentang reported speech. Okay, let's start our lesson. Let's check it out. Okay, reported speech. Another word for reported speech is indirect speech. Jadi, kata lain dari reported speech itu sama aja dengan indirect speech. Jadi, sama ya. Indirect speech sama dengan reported speech. And we use reported speech to report or to write down what somebody had said. Jadi kita menggunakan reported speech ini untuk melaporkan atau menuliskan kembali apa yang seseorang telah katakan. So you have to be careful not to change their word. Jadi Anda harus hati-hati agar tidak mengubah katanya, dalam arti tidak mengubah arti katanya. Itu dia. Okay? And in reported speech, we will focus on the changes in subject and pronoun, tenses, and also adverb. Jadi, dalam nanti kita mempelajari reported speech, kita akan memfokuskan pada perubahan yang terjadi dalam subject, dalam pronoun, tensesnya, dan adverbnya. Okay, let's start the first one. The changes of tenses from direct speech to indirect speech or reported speech, ya. Jadi, perubahan tenses, ini kuncinya, the key changes of tenses from direct speech to indirect speech, or we call it reported speech. Jadi, ini kata kunci buat perubahan tenses-tenses dari yang direct speech, dari ucapan langsung ke ucapan tidak langsung, atau kita sebut dengan reported speech atau indirect speech. Nah, ini bisa dilihat direct speech-nya, ucapan langsungnya. Kalau ada present, tenses-nya akan berubah menjadi past. Nah, indirect speech sama aja reported speech ya. Lalu ada past tense, akan berubah menjadi past perfect. Future berubah menjadi past future. Kalau ada will, modal will, can atau may, it will change into, akan berubah menjadi would, could, or might. Lalu ada must, has to, atau have to. Ini bisa berubah menjadi had to. Okay, let's check it out. Nah, ini dia. Contoh-contohnya, misalkan yang tadi present berubah menjadi past tense. Ya, jadi simple present berubah menjadi simple past. Example, for example, she always wears a coat. He said that she always wore a coat. Lihat yang tanda merah ini adalah perubahannya. Dari kata kerja bentuk pertama, yaitu present, berubah menjadi kata kerja bentuk kedua, yaitu past tense. Miss, kenapa di sini he? Ini berarti ada tiga orang. Misalkan dia dia perempuan, dia laki-laki, dan saya. Saya, jadi dia perempuan ini sedang berbicara. Dan dia bilang, she always wears a coat. Lalu saya tanya ke teman saya yang laki-laki. Nah, apa yang dia perempuan katakan? Berarti teman saya bilang, he said that she ini teman saya yang perempuan, always wore a coat. Okay? Lalu, next, present continuous change into past continuous. Jadi, dari present continuous berubah menjadi past continuous. Lihat, I'm looking for my keys. She said that she was looking for her keys. Ini kebetulan reported verb-nya, ini kita sebut dengan reported verb. She was looking for her keys, itu namanya reported words. Okay? Nah, jadi yang merah-merah ini perubahannya bisa dilihat dari present menjadi past. Jadi dari present continuous menjadi past continuous. Dari am looking menjadi was looking. Lalu present perfect. Change into past perfect. Berubah menjadi past perfect. They have had a shower. They said that they had had a shower. Lihat, yang tanda merah itu adalah perubahannya. Present perfect continuous. She has been writing two letters for her friends. Change into berubah menjadi past perfect continuous. She said that she had been writing two letters for her friends. Okay, next. From past tense to past perfect. Jadi simple past menjadi past perfect. Jadi he took my photograph. He said that he had taken my photograph. Dia sudah mengambil foto saya. Dia mengatakan bahwa dia telah mengambil foto saya. Past continuous change into past perfect continuous. She was painting become. Jadinya she said that she had been painting. Okay. And then. Past perfect. I had had a cat. Change into past perfect. He said that he had had a cat. Past perfect continuous. My friend had been giving me a chocolate. Kalau sudah seperti itu, kalau udah past perfect ya past perfect. Tetap tidak ada perubahan. Cuman hanya ditambahkan reported verb-nya. Ya, he said that his friend had been giving him a chocolate. Perubahannya ada dari my menjadi his. Karena di sini he said. Ya, kalau she said that her friend had been giving her a chocolate. Jadi tergantung siapa yang mengucapkannya. Oke, disesuaikan ya. Next. Future, future berubah menjadi past future. Dari simple future become simple past future. I will read a novel. She said that she would read a novel. Will become would. Future continuous become past future continuous. He will be traveling around the world. He said that he would be traveling around the world. Okay. Next, future perfect become past future perfect. Yeah, she will have bought a house. She said that she would have bought a house. Yeah. Tinggal dirubah dari simple menjadi past. Future perfect continuous. Nah, ini udah ada perfect, ada future-nya, tinggal kasih past karena ini masih simple. Jadi past, future, perfect continuous. They will have been inviting everyone. They said that they would have been inviting everyone. Okay, next. Nah, kalau tadi ada changes of the tenses, kalau tadi ada perubahan pada tensesnya, subjek atau pronounnya, di sini kita membahas tentang the changes of the adverb. Jadi perubahan pada kata keterangannya. Khususnya di sini, contohnya saya kasih contoh adverb of time, keterangan waktu. Jadi today changed to that day or the same day. Hari ini diubah menjadi hari itu atau hari yang sama. Misalkan I watch TV today. Berarti he said that she watch TV that day. Nah, jadi watch-nya dari subjeknya. Tadi kan I, karena saya ini perempuan, berarti she. Digantinya she watch, watch-nya verb 2. TV today berubah menjadi that day. Okay, next. Tomorrow changes to the next day or the following day. Jadi besok diubah menjadi hari berikutnya. The next day. Atau bisa juga pakai the following day. Choose one of these ya. Pilih salah satu aja. Yesterday changes to the day before or the previous day. Jadi yang kemarin diubah menjadi the day before, satu hari sebelumnya. Or the previous day, the same. Next week, next month, next year. Change into the following week or the following month or the following year. Jadi tinggal dicocokkan aja. Last week, last month, or last year. Changes into the previous week, the previous month, and the previous year. Jangan ditulis begini ya, tapi salah satu aja. Choose one of these. Salah satu. Now or just. Kalau ada now, berubah menjadi then, Oh, begitu juga sebaliknya kalau ada just changes to then, berubah menjadi then. Ago ini biasanya dalam past tense ya. Ini changes to before. Jadi kalau ada kata-kata ago harus diubah menjadi before. Good. Here changes to there. Di sini berubah menjadi di sana. Oke, this changes to that. Ini berubah menjadi itu. Nah, oke, ini perubahan dalam adverb-nya kalau kita menggunakan reported speech. Oke, next. Nah, if there is modal like should, ought to, might, would, and could. Jadi kalau ada modal, modalnya yang dipakai itu adalah should seharusnya, ought to juga seharusnya, might mungkin saja, would akan, and could dapat. Ini there is no differences, no changing. Jadi tidak ada perbedaan, tidak ada perubahan. But remember, you must make the what you call it reported verb. Nah, harus ada ininya nih. Ada said that, apa denied that, atau stated that or claimed that. Pokoknya reported verb-nya itu harus ada. Oke, di sini contohnya they say we will apply for a visa. They said that. Nah, they said that. Itu namanya reported verbs. Oke. They would apply for visa. Ini namanya reported words. Oke, good. She said she could play a piano. She said that she could play a piano. Ini salah ya, bukan violin. He said guests might come. Mungkin boleh datang. He said that guests might come. Oke. He said I should avail the opportunity. He said that he should avail the opportunity. Jadi kata-katanya sama, tidak ada perubahan. Cuman tenses-nya yang berubah. Tapi karena di sini ada special word, would, could, might, should, and ought to, berarti tidak ada perubahan. No changing ya. Ought to, seharusnya. He said to me, you ought to wait for them. He said to me that I ought to wait for them. Okay, understand? Next. Ini ada special case in reported speech. Ada kata-kata special yang sama seperti tadi modalnya would, should, itu tidak ada perubahan. No meaning changing or no pattern changing in tenses. Jadi artinya nggak berubah. Struktur tensesnya juga nggak berubah. Jika, nah, reporting verb-nya. Apa sih reporting verb ini loh, yang ini loh. They say, all people will say, Rehan has say. Nah, reporting verb ini, kalau dalam bentuk simple present tense, simple future tense, present perfect tense, so the reported words-nya no changing. Jadi reported words-nya yang mana nih? We are happy. Nobody is perfect. I have not good idea for that. Ini kita sebut dengan reported words. Jadi kalau ada reporting verb ini, simple present tense, future tense, and perfect tense, so the reporting words-nya no changing. Jadi di reporting words-nya tidak ada perubahan. Seperti ini, tinggal ditambahkan that. They say conjunction-nya ya. They say that they are happy. They say we are happy. Lalu indirect-nya, they say that they are happy. All people will say nobody is perfect. All people will say that nobody is perfect. Rehan has said, I haven't good idea for that. Rehan has said, he hasn't good idea for that. Okay. Remember this. Okay. Next. Okay. I think that's all for today about reported speech. Goodbye. See you in other slides. I hope you will like this and then you will comment and share. Thank you for watching. See you in another slide. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.